In this video, I'm going to be solving the problem 4.19 as it appears on Griffiths Introduction to Quantum Mechanics 3rd edition. The problem states that the raising and lowering operator changes the value of m by 1 unit. This means that if you apply L plus or minus to some state, you're going to get some constant times that same state, but with the value of m either increased or decreased by 1. And the question is, what is this constant if this LFL m plus or minus 1 is normalized? Basically, if these new states are normalized, what is this constant? So to do that, let us begin by writing what we have up here in Dirac notation. So basically, let's write it as ket. This is equal to ALM and some ket. Right, but we know that writing it like this is actually the same as writing it like this. And we saw that in the properties for Dirac notation a few videos ago. Now let's take a look. These is the ket form. Let's now take the bra of this. So L plus or minus F L M. This is going to be equal to the bra of F L M plus or minus 1 A L M. Okay, so this is going to be its conjugate. Now, what can we do with this? Well, let us now basically multiply these two equations. And why we want to do that? We want to do that so that we can get the inner product, because inner product is going to be the brat multiplying the ket. And with that, we are going to get, since these states are supposedly normalized, then what we are going to get is we're only going to be left with these operators. We're going to get rid of the bras and kets, and that's very useful. So let's do that. So let's see, this left hand side is going to be bra L plus or minus FLM, L plus or minus FLM, and this is going to be equal to FLM plus or minus 1 ALM conjugate ALM FLM plus or minus 1. Okay, and what we have in here is just going to be the modulus of A LM squared. That's just by definition. Z conjugate Z is just going to be modulus of Z squared, right? There's nothing new going on there. As since this is just a constant, we can actually put it outside of this inner product. And since we are asked what happens when this state is normalized, and it is usually going to be normalized, because remember, whenever we are dealing with some wave function in physics, we like to make sure that it's normalized before we finish the work and start looking for observables. So this is usually going to be normalized, which means that this is going to be 1. Now let's take a look at the left hand side. And actually, let me take this to the next page, so that I have a bit more room to work with. Okay, so what can we do here? Well, this left part, we have this L plus or minus acting on this bra, right? But we know that we could also write this as FLM and then put the operator on this side, but take its Hermitian adjoint, right? That's something that we saw also a few videos ago. So when we do that, we could rewrite this like this. Okay, but what is this amount? What is this quantity? So remember, L plus or minus is LX plus or minus ILY. So what do we get? And well, this is not a vector, so we can just take the normal conjugate. So what do we get in this case? We get LX minus or plus I L Y, right? And this is simply L minus or plus. So instead of having L plus or minus, we get L minus plus. So let's actually write this in here. So here we get L minus plus. So now let's take a look. Oh, I'm actually missing that line. Okay, now let's take a look at this operation here. So that's going to be L minus plus L plus minus acting on this state. So let's take a look at the product L minus plus L plus minus. So what is this? This is going to be Lx minus plus Ily times Lx plus or minus Ily. So let's multiply this. So we get Lx squared, then we have plus or minus Ilx Ly when we multiply this and this, and we also have minus plus Ily Lx, and finally we have minus plus is minus, plus minus this is minus, but then we have I times I, which is another minus, so it's going to be positive, plus Ly squared. Okay, and remember, L squared minus Lz squared, this is exactly Lx squared plus Ly squared. So we can actually write this as L squared minus Lz squared plus or minus Ilx Ly minus plus Ily Lx. But let us now begin to work with this expression. So let's begin by factoring out plus or minus I from this. So when we do that, the plus or minus from this first part just stays outside, this I goes outside, and what happens to this? Well, if this is plus and this is supposed to be a minus, then we need to have a minus here. And if this is minus and this is supposed to be a plus, we need a minus there as well. So this is just going to be minus. And what we have in here is actually just a commutator between Lx and Ly, Lx, Ly, right? Lx Ly minus Ly Lx, that's just a commutator. So this is going to be plus or minus I, the commutator between Lx and Ly. But what is the value of this? We have already calculated it. This is simply I h bar Lz. And here we have I times I, which is going to be minus. But minus is now going to flip this from plus minus to minus plus. So this is what we are left with. This is L minus plus, L plus and minus. So let us now let it act on our FLM. So all of this is going to be acting on FLM. We already know how these operators act on some state. We saw that in the previous video. When L squared acts on it, we are going to get h bar squared L, L plus 1. When Lz squared acts, we are going to get hm for each time that Lz acts, so it's going to be hm squared. And then we have minus or plus h bar times h bar m, so we get h bar squared m. And all of this still acting on FLM. So here we can actually factor out a little bit, so we get h bar squared factor of L, L plus 1, minus, and here we can also factor out a minus m, so we get minus m, m plus or minus 1, right? Because since we factor out a minus sign, this minus or plus changes back to plus minus. Okay, so this is still acting on FLM. Now let us put this back into this expression, because we know what all of this is. This is just all of these constants times FLM. And since they are just constants, we can actually take them outside of this, and we're going to be left with h bar squared L plus 1 minus m plus or minus 1. And this is going to be times FLM. But this is going to be 1 if this state is normalized. Okay, and since this right here is the same as what we had up there, right, we here only rewrote this part, this is going to be the same as ALM squared. So let us now, and as you see, now we are left with only an equation that only involves constants. That's what we wanted. These are just scalars. There's no more kets or bras involved. And now we can take the square root of all of this, and we see that ALM is going to be h bar times the square root of L L plus 1, actually I think this is parentheses is not necessary, minus m, m plus or minus 1. So now we know the constant that we have to put in front whenever we let the raising or lowering operators act on some state. So what we did in this problem basically was we wrote this in terms that we could manipulate algebraically, so we used Dirac notation, and as we can see, it really allows us to do a lot of things quite easily. And then, well, we had this in ket form, but we couldn't really get rid of our state, so we wrote this in bra form and then applied the inner product so that we could get rid of these kets and bras. And we also had to use in this part right here the fact that we can write this operator like outside of this bra, but we had to write it as the Hermitian adjoint. And well, we calculate what it is, then we just have to apply calculate this product right here, which we did, and that just gave us all of the constants. And since the states are normalized, we could just basically discard them whenever the inner product was 1. And that's how we got this result. So I will see you in the next video.